right, ladies and gentlemen, I want to give you a couple examples from our Lesson 2 Applying Exponent Properties worksheet. What we're looking at here is number 3. Couple hints. When I'm doing a problem like this, I'm going to first expand it out, write everything out as I can, and then try to simplify it. So when I'm looking at this one, I'm going to view it all as multiplication. This is 2 times v to the second power times 3 times v to the first power. We do not write the 1, but it's there. Now looking at this, I'm going to look for things I can multiply. I can multiply 2 and 3. So I'm going to multiply those together. And I'm going to go 2 times 3 to get 6. Now I'm going to look at this v to the second and v to the first. Okay? If it helps, write it as v to the second times v to the first. The more you write out, the easier it might be. Same base, multiplying, that means we add the exponents. So this becomes 6 times v to the third. And I would accept either of these. In fact, we probably shouldn't even write the time sign. So I'd accept any 3 of these. But notice what I did. I wrote out all the multiplication. Don't forget that we can multiply 2 and 3 together, not add them, we're multiplying. And then using our properties, same base multiplying, add the exponents. The next one I want to look at is number 10, I believe. Okay, you got to be careful because of this division bar. Okay, so when I write this out, I have an 8 on the bottom. It's not here, but we could put a 1 in. So this is the reason I do that. I'm going to write 1 over 8, and I'm going to group everything together. I'm going to group my x to the third over x, but I'm going to write it x to the first. And I'm going to have this as y to the fifth over y to the fourth. Sorry about the interruption there. So anyway, back to this problem. This 1 over 8, I can't do anything with. So I'm going to write 1 over 8. Now, if I could reduce it, some of your problems want you to reduce it. Okay. If I think one of the problems has, you could write it as 8 tenths. Well, you can divide both of those by 2 to get 4 fifths. Okay, so if you can reduce it, do so. Now look at here. A lot of people were adding, but we have same base dividing. Here, we had same base multiplying, so we added. Same base dividing, we subtract. And I'm going to write the subtraction sign. Same base dividing, we subtract. So when we put this all together, I can actually put ones underneath here. So I can multiply across the top. 1 times x to, if you left it 3 minus 1 is fine, or you can write it x to the second, times y to the first, over 8 times 1 times 1, which is just 8. So the best way to write this, but even if you got this far, I'd be good, is x to the second, actually, just y. If you had a 1 there, it'd be okay, over 8. That's our simplified version. Okay. But again, with both of these problems, guys, especially number 10, this was probably the most involved. Notice how I wrote it out, spread it out, applied our properties. If we're dividing, fraction bar, we subtract. If we're multiplying, we add. So use these two examples to maybe fix any of the other problems you have on the worksheet and see me if you need help.